Welcome to worship with the Presbyterian Church of Milford, and sit back and enjoy the Christmas story as we all know it so well. Join me for our call to worship. Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord.
Great news of a great joy, a Savior born to us, a Savior strong and mighty, a warrior among all people.
And this shall be the sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger.
Great Savior, a baby, wrapped in bands of cloth, in a manger? Where is our warrior king? Where is the Savior to free us all from that what holds us down?
And suddenly there was with the angels of heaven a chorus praising God and shouting, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all people."
A Savior, baby king, God in flesh, let us go and find this miracle child born to us, Savior of the world.
Begin. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests on his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish it and uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord host will do this.
Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and is this the sixth month for her, who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, then you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. Creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child you're holding is the great
of Jesus the Messiah took place this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the Virgin Mary shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife. But they had no marital relations until she had borne a son and named him Jesus.
stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the song found its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder will break a new and glorious morn. Oh, glory, oh, reign, oh, hear the angel voices on thy divine, oh, night when Christ was born.
All chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise thee, let all
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration, and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was a descendant from the house of the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Helpless and hungry, lonely, afraid, wrapped in the chill of midwinter, comes now among us, born into poverty's embrace, new life for the world. Who lives with the lowly, sharing their sorrows, knowing their hunger. This is Christ revealed to the world in the eyes of the child, child of the poor. What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch our keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds, God, and angels sing. Haste to bring him round, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Who is the stranger here in our midst, looking for shelter among us? Who is the outcast? Who do we see amid the poor, the children of God? Who is this who lives with the lonely, sharing their sorrows, knowing their hunger? This is Christ revealed to the world in the eyes of a child, child of the poor.
Why lies he in such mean estate, where rocks and grass are feeding? Good Christian, fear for sinners here, the silent word is pleading. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds, God, and angels sing. Haste to bring him on, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense cold and myrrh, come presently to own him. The King of Kings, a patient friend, let loving hearts around him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds, God, and angels see.
This is
Christ, haste to bring him on, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Who is this?
This is Christ the King,
sharing their
shepherds, God, and angels.
This is Christ,
haste to bring him on, the babe, the Son of Mary.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of a great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth lying in the manger." And suddenly there was with it the angel of multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
The time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the spirit of his son into your hearts, crying, "Abba, Father." So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. Formerly, when you did not know God, you were enslaved to beings that by nature are not gods.
My love, my treasured one, are you, my sweet and lovely son, are you. You are my love, my darling, you, unworthy I of you. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Son, I will.
Why God allowed his son to be born in a manger. He who could have had the most that heaven and earth together could offer settled instead for the least. So what can we learn about Jesus and why he came from that simple birth in a little manger? First, it's fitting that the Lamb of God should be born surrounded with animals, many of whom were to be used in sacrifice. The second, the manger made him accessible. Shepherds hurrying to the stables did not have to flash identification cards to get by. Wise men didn't have to write for an interview or sit in a waiting room while their credentials were cleared by some secret service agent. And third, the manger demonstrated his attitude of simplicity. Things were never important to Jesus. People were and still are. He always moved toward them and into their lives. He chose to be born in the borrowed stable, away from everything comfortable and easy. Does that surprise you? Later, he said that when he slept, he had no bed. And he borrowed a basket that bright spring morning before he sent away people fully fed. He borrowed a boat from which to preach his father's love to men who stood that day on Galilee's beach, wanting to hear his message again. He borrowed a donkey on which to ride in Jerusalem. And he borrowed a room in which to meet his friends and have a last supper together. He borrowed a table at which to eat and a towel he used to dry his disciples' feet was not his own. He borrowed a cross on which to die and he even borrowed a tomb in which to lie. And yet the whole universe was his to enjoy. Now he's looking for a life to share. It doesn't have to be regal, elegant, or fancy. In fact, the plainer, the simpler, the better. Just an open heart in which he can move. Maybe yours. Tonight, of all nights, when we hear this wonderful Christmas story retold, as we listen to beautiful Christmas music, our hearts are filled with joy and wonder, and yet, what will our hearts feel like tomorrow with all the festivities we will all enjoy? Will we really remember tonight? Are our hearts only borrowed for the night, or has Jesus really found a place in which to grow? As we all reflect back on this night, will we say it was nice service, or will it be a night when you say, this is the night I allowed Jesus to fill my heart. To fill my heart and my night, my fire for Christ started burning again brightly inside of me. A night when we say my heart was not borrowed for just a short time, but offered over to Christ for eternity. What better time than in this crazy year of 2020? Let your light shine bright and share that light with all of those around you. Amen.
This silent night, many of us will be safe at home, wrapping or unwrapping presents. Families reunited and full of good cheer, enjoying rum-soaked fruitcake, decorated sugar cookies, and mulled cider, warming themselves by the hearth and leaving milk and cookies for Santa. This holy night, we have gathered here, full of mercy, recalling the many years we have gathered this evening, full of promise, anticipating the many years we will gather on future Christmas Eves. All is calm, all is bright. Tonight, we illuminate this space with our candles. In more ways than one, we are the light of this congregation. God of our hearts, minds, and spirits, we are deeply grateful for all the blessings of our lives. Grateful we are together here on this holy night. We know there are those in peril this night of peace, those serving our nations overseas and protecting us here at home. There are others who are homeless, hungry, and friendless tonight, who will not find shelter, food, and love that everyone deserves. As we celebrate our good fortune, we also remember their need. We wish an end to their suffering, just as much as we wish an end to our own moments of suffering. For we intuitively know that we are all connected. Tonight, let us find heaven's peace. May we know the reality of the holy, unconditional love that binds ourselves together, forms the foundation of every community, and guides each one of us back again and again to our source. Jesus knew that reality and embodied it. Buddha pursued that reality and awakened to it. Through our commitment, dedication, and the abundant grace of God, we can discover that reality too. This holy night, we give thanks for the gift of life. Thanks for all the love we have received, and rededicate ourselves to share and to serve that love that in reality is our true nature. For at the core of that love, there is joy. God of life and God of hope, we give you thanks and praise this night as we gather to remember the birth of Jesus, who came as a witness to grace, who proclaimed peace, did justice, lived love, and walked humbly with you. In his name we pray for peace and healing wherever your world is broken, wherever violence and injustice reign, wherever your children are in pain. We ask that we might follow Jesus faithfully and so become answers to our prayers for peace on earth, goodwill for all people, and wholeness and well-being for all creation. Amen.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing.
Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Jesus said, you are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all of the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven.
Holy infant's
As you leave your TVs or your computer screens, my hope is that Christ's light has filled your hearts, has brightened your lives one more day, and that you'll be able to share this light with all of those around you, and that it will shine bright all your days ahead. And as you leave this place, may the shalom of God, the love and compassion of Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit be with us all. And Merry Christmas, everyone.